The legislature returns to work this week, and some people are hoping lawmakers will take action on a big problem in Wisconsin: repeat drunken drivers. A number of bills to deal with repeat offenders have been introduced, but lawmakers who were grappling with a massive state budget deficit earlier this year have not acted on them yet. One bill would make fourth offense OWI a felony. Currently, it's not a felony until the fifth offense. Another bill would require ignition interlocks for some offenders. State Representative Tony Staskunas of West Allis is sponsoring those bills in the Assembly, and he's with us today. Thanks very much for being with us, Representative.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Well, I guess the question now is, you have a few differences between the Senate and the Assembly versions of these bills. Are you going to be able to reconcile them and have meaningful reform?
Well, we will definitely have meaningful reform this session. The Assembly bill that we are working on is going to be on the floor next week. And you're right, I have been working with the Senate to try to reconcile those differences. I do think it would be easier and would expedite the process if we could bring those two bills together. We still have a few differences, but nonetheless, our bill is going to be on the Assembly floor next week, and I think it makes some very meaningful changes.
Those differences aren't great enough to perhaps sidetrack legislation?
I don't think so. I don't think so at this point. I mean, the differences are quite small, but, you know, there's some details that need to be worked out, some things on financing the proposals and things like that. But, again, it's only September. We still have a lot of time to work on these things.
You describe the changes as meaningful. Give us a couple of examples of what people in the state of Wisconsin will see when it comes to a toughening of drunk driving laws.
Well, the bill's a combination of treatment, prevention, and punishment. On the treatment side, we have something allowing drug courts now, which will allow oversight to supervise their treatment. We'll allow probation now for second and third drunk drivers. So again, probation officers will now be able to really watch their treatment progress. We will require ignition interlocks, and this would include first-time offenders who have a high blood alcohol content. The point there would be to change behaviors. We want them to get used to getting behind the wheel, not drinking. And then making fourth time a felony, as you mentioned. Currently it's a fifth time. We would go to a fourth time. And again, so for those repeaters, they need to be punished.
You've heard this. Some family members who have lost loved ones to drunken drivers say, we still feel like this is nibbling around the edges. We don't have sobriety checkpoints. We don't make a first offense a crime as it is in other states. What do you say to those folks?
Well, I say I'm very sorry you lost a loved one, and you know, it makes me angry when people lose loved ones like that. So I completely understand where they're coming from. The other thing I would tell them is that you know, I really believe in this issue, and I'm going to do the best I can to get the best bill. And I would hope they would put a little trust in me. I've been in the legislature 12 years. I think I have a pretty good feel about what we can pass and what we can't pass. I've talked to a lot of legislators. I think I have a feel for where things are coming down, and I think we're going to be able to pass the bill that can get enough votes and actually get some meaningful reform.
So it's what's possible. That's the bottom line here, what you can get done.
Well, right. I mean, it would be excellent if every bill that I introduced in the legislature got passed exactly how I wanted it, but that doesn't happen for me or any legislators. We have to work on things. We have to get our votes together. You have to bring coalitions of people together. And again, that with a comprehensive bill like this, too, you know, you add something in, maybe one or two person jumps onto the bill, but then somebody jumps off. And so you're trying to bring the votes together to pass the bill.
You have been working on this issue 6 or 7 years, and yet there's the feeling that now there is this perfect storm, maybe because of some high-profile cases, maybe it's because the state's largest newspaper, the Journal Sentinel, focused on this. Why do you think we're ready for changes at this point?
I think both of those things that you just mentioned, the media attention has really focused on this and I think has elevated the profile for all the citizens throughout the state of Wisconsin. Some high-profile tragedies have done it. You know, at times I just think that, yeah, the legislature kind of comes around to different issues, and I think this is the session that drunk driving has really been focused on, and therefore, you know, we're ready to go on it.
Representative Tony Staskunas, the Democrat from West Allis, thanks very much for being with us. We do appreciate it.
Okay, you're welcome.
And we will be right back with a word about this week's Web Extra.
Upfront is produced with editorial assistance from WizPolitics.com, an online public affairs news magazine and resource on public policy issues.